Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss one of the important water soluble vitamin, that is vitamin B12. Learning objective for today's video are: first we will see structure, different forms, absorption, transport and storage of vitamin B12. Then we will see biochemical functions of vitamin B12, and in the end we will discuss deficiency manifestation of vitamin B12 along with NEET PG MCQs. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. Before going in the detail of vitamin B12, first let's see type of the questions that can be asked from this particular topic in theory exams. So the long answer questions like, write a detailed essay on absorption, transport, biochemical functions and deficiency manifestation of vitamin B12. Short notes or brief answers like, pollen trap, biochemical functions of vitamin B12 and absorption of vitamin B12. Logical reasoning or justifications like, vitamin B12 deficiency causes excretion of methylmalonic acid in urine. Vitamin B12 is also known as a cobalamine, and another names of vitamin B12 are extrinsic factor of Castle and anti-pernicious anemia factor. It is a water soluble, heat stable and red in color. It contains 4.35% cobalt by weight. Structure of vitamin B12. So vitamin B12 bears a complex corine ring linked to cobalt atom held in the center of the corine ring by four coordination bonds with the nitrogen of the pyrrole groups. The fifth valency of the cobalt is covalently linked to substituted benzimidazole ring, and the sixth valency of the cobalt is satisfied by any one of the following groups like cyanide, hydroxyl, adenosyl or methyl. This is the picture showing the structure of vitamin B12, which consists of corine ring. Structure of corine ring is similar to that of porphyrin ring. And four pyrrole rings coordinated with cobalt atom is called as a corine ring. And this cobalt atom is bind to the nitrogen atoms of the four pyrrole groups. And the fifth valency of the cobalt is satisfied by the nitrogen of the dimethyl benzimidazole ring. And the sixth valency of the cobalt is satisfied by the R group. In the R group, it can be either methyl, deoxyadenosyl or hydroxy group. So this is the picture showing the structure of vitamin B12. Now we will see various forms of vitamin B12. So the first form is cyanocobalamin. In the cyanocobalamin, cyanide group has no physiological function. It is only laboratory artifact. And the oral preparations are in this form. Second form is hydroxycobalamin. Injectable preparations are in this form. Third and important form is adenosyl cobalamin. When taken up by the cells, these groups are removed and deoxyadenosyl cobalamin is formed, and it is the major storage form seen in the liver. Fourth and another important form is methylcobalamin, which is the major form seen in the blood circulation. So adenosyl B12 and methyl B12 are the functional coenzymes present in the body. So that is about various forms of vitamin B12. Now we will see dietary sources of vitamin B12. So dietary sources of vitamin B12 are of animal origin, like meat, eggs, milk, dairy products, fish. Liver is the richest source and curd is also a good source because lactobacillus can synthesize vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is absent in the plant foods, and humans obtain small amounts of vitamin B12 from the intestinal flora. Another vitamins which can be synthesized from intestinal flora are vitamin K and riboflavin. Nutritional requirements of vitamin B12. So the normal daily requirement of vitamin B12 is 1 to 2 microgram per day. During pregnancy and lactation, this is increased to 2 microgram per day. Those who take folic acid should also take vitamin B12, and aged people are advised to take vitamin B12 supplementation. Now we will see absorption, transport and storage of vitamin B12. So The intestinal absorption of vitamin B12 requires an intrinsic factor of Kessel, which is a glycoprotein secreted by parietal cells of the stomach. In stomach, intrinsic factor binds to the dietary vitamin B12 to form vitamin B12 intrinsic factor complex. This complex binds to specific receptors on the surface of the mucosal cells of the ileum. And after binding to the receptor, the bound vitamin B12 is released from the complex and enters the ileal mucosal cells through calcium-dependent process. This is the picture showing this absorption, transport, and storage of vitamin B12. There are two important factors required for the absorption of vitamin B12. First one is the intrinsic factor of Kessel, which is secreted by the parietal cells of the stomach, and second one is the cobalophilin, which is secreted in the saliva. So gastric pepsin releases the vitamin from the proteins of the food, and then vitamin B12 binds with the cobalophilin. In duodenum, cobalophilin is released by trypsin of the pancreatic juice. Then vitamin is released and it is binds to the intrinsic factor. In pancreatic insufficiency, there is an absence of trypsin and vitamin may not be released. So vitamin cobalophilin complex is excreted, resulting in vitamin deficiency. Now this intrinsic factor vitamin B12 complex is attached with the specific receptors present in the mucosal cells of the ileum. And then whole intrinsic factor and vitamin B12 complex is internalized. It may be noted that vitamin B12 is absorbed from the ileum while folic acid is absorbed from the jejunum. Inside the ileum, vitamin B12 is converted to the methyl B12 and it is dissociated from intrinsic factor of Kessel. Now this methyl B12 is transported in the blood with the help of one plasma protein which is synthesized by the liver, that is transcobalamin. And the 90% of the vitamin B12 is taken up by the liver via portal circulation, and in the liver it is stored in the form of deoxyadenosyl vitamin B12. Unlike other water soluble vitamins which are not stored in the body, liver can store sufficient vitamin B12, that is around 1 to 2 milligram, which can cater the need of body for next 3 to 4 years. So that is about absorption, transport and storage of vitamin B12. Now biochemical functions of vitamin B12. So there are only two human enzyme systems that are known to require vitamin B12 as a coenzyme. First one is isomerization of methylmalonyl-CoA to succinyl-CoA, and second one is conversion of homocysteine to methionine. So these are the two human enzyme systems which require vitamin B12 as a coenzyme. This is the picture showing the isomerization of methylmalonyl-CoA to succinyl-CoA. So methylmalonyl-CoA is synthesized as the end product of metabolism of various odd number carbon fatty acids, amino acids and pyrimidines. Then this methylmalonyl-CoA is isomerized to the succinyl-CoA, which enters into the TCA cycle and it is required for the synthesis of porphyrin. Now if there is a deficiency of vitamin B12, then methylmalonyl-CoA mutase will not be able to convert methylmalonyl-CoA to the succinyl-CoA. So there will be the accumulation of methylmalonyl-CoA, and this methylmalonyl-CoA will be excreted in the urine in the form of methylmalonic acid. So this is the role of vitamin B12 in the isomerization of methylmalonyl-CoA to the succinyl-CoA. Second enzyme system which requires vitamin B12 as a coenzyme is conversion of homocysteine to methionine. And this is the only mammalian reaction which requires two vitamins, that is vitamin B12 and folic acid. So this is the picture showing the conversion of homocysteine to methionine by methionine synthase, which require cobalamin as well as methyl tetrahydrofolate. So during this reaction, methyl group from cobalamin is transferred to the homocysteine. So homocysteine is converted to the methionine, and this cobalamin removes the methyl group from methyl tetrahydrofolate. So methyl tetrahydrofolate is converted to the free tetrahydrofolate. So this free tetrahydrofolate can take part in various one carbon reactions. If there is a deficiency of vitamin B12, then there is no conversion of this methyl tetrahydrofolate into the free tetrahydrofolate, and it results in the folate trap. So this is the second reactions which require vitamin B12 as a coenzyme. Now we will see causes of vitamin B12 deficiency. So the first cause is nutritional. So the only source of vitamin B12 in the vegetarian diet is curd and milk, and in lower income group may not be able to afford it. It results in vitamin B12 deficiency. Second important cause for vitamin B12 deficiency, decreased absorption. So gastrectomy, resection of the ileum, and malabsorption syndromes results in vitamin B12 deficiency. Third important cause of vitamin B12 deficiency is Addisonian pernicious anemia. It is an autoimmune disorder. There is a production of antibodies against intrinsic factor of Kassel. But this disorder is very rare in India but common in European countries. So there is no absorption of vitamin B12. It is manifested usually in persons over 40 years. As I have already mentioned, antibodies are generated against intrinsic factors. So intrinsic factors becomes deficient, leading to defective absorption of vitamin B12. Fourth important cause is gastric atrophy. So it results in defective absorption of vitamin B12. In chronic iron deficiency anemia, there is a generalized mucosal atrophy. Again, it results in vitamin B12 deficiency. Fifth important cause is pregnancy. So during pregnancy, requirement is increased. So it results in vitamin B12 deficiency. Then another important cause of vitamin B12 deficiency is the fish tapeworm, like Diphyllo Bodrium latum, which has a special affinity to B12, causing reduction in available vitamin. Now we will see deficiency manifestation of vitamin B12. The first one is the folate trap. So vitamin B12 deficiency causes the simultaneous folate deficiency due to the folate trap. Second manifestation of vitamin B12 deficiency is megaloblastic anemia. In the peripheral blood, megaloblasts, immature nucleated RBCs, and hyperpigmented neutrophils are observed. Third manifestation of vitamin B12 deficiency is abnormal homocysteine level. So due to the folate trap, homocysteine is accumulated, which results in homocystinuria. Homocysteine level in the blood has positive correlation with myocardial infarction. Fourth and important manifestation of vitamin B12 deficiency is subacute combined degeneration. So damage to the nervous system is seen in B12 deficiency, but it is not seen in folic acid deficiency. There is a demyelination affecting the dorsal column and pyramidal tract of spinal cord. Since sensory and motor tracts are affected, it is named as combined degeneration. Symmetrical paresthesia of extremities, alteration of tendon and deep senses and reflexes, loss of position sense, unsteadiness in gait, positive Romberg sign, that is falling when eyes are closed, and positive Babinski sign, that is extensor plantar reflex, are seen in subacute combined degeneration, which occurs due to the vitamin B12 deficiency. This is the picture showing the Romberg position. Eyes are closed, legs are fixed. And this is the picture showing the Babinski reflex, which is elucidated by one sharp object from lateral border of the foot starting from the calcaneus. If there is a extensor plantar reflex, that is extensor of the great toe with the fanning of the other fingers, then this reflex is considered as a positive Babinski reflex. So this is the Romberg position, which is done for the Romberg sign. This is the Babinski reflex. Another deficiency manifestation of vitamin B12 is demyelination. As active methionine is not available, so methylation of phosphatidyl ethanolamine to phosphatidyl choline is not adequate. This leads to deficient formation of myelin sheaths of nerves, demyelination, and neurological lesions. Fifth deficiency manifestation is achlorhydria. Absence of acid in gastric juice is associated with vitamin B12 deficiency. Sixth important manifestation of vitamin B12 deficiency is seen in the nails. Vitamin B12 deficiency is manifested in the nail as a parallel ridges. This is the picture of peripheral smear showing the megaloblastic anemia. There is a presence of normoblasts, that is immature RBCs, and hypersegmented neutrophils. And this is the picture of parallel ridges which is seen in the nail. Now, assessment of vitamin B12 deficiency. The first one is serum B12 level can be assessed by radioimmunoassay or by enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Then peripheral smear. So in the peripheral smear, peripheral blood and bone marrow shows typical picture of megaloblastic anemia that we have already seen in the previous slide. And Skilling test. In the Skilling test, radioactive labeled vitamin B12, 1 microgram is given orally, and simultaneously intramuscular injection of unlabeled vitamin B12 is given in order to saturate tissues with normal vitamin B12. So radioactive vitamin B12 will not bind to the body tissues. Therefore, in normal person, the entire absorbed radioactivity will pass into the urine. And in patients with pernicious anemia, less than 5% of the radioactivity will be detected in the urine. Another way to detect vitamin B12 deficiency is methylmalonic acid, which is present in the urine. Then by Figlu test, so Figlu excretion test will be positive in vitamin B12 deficiency. Another one is homocystinuria, so homocystin will be excreted in the urine. Normal range or normal biological reference interval of vitamin B12 is 160 to 950 picogram per ml. Now, treatment of vitamin B12 deficiency. So all microcytic anemias are generally treated with folate and vitamin B12. Therapeutic doses of vitamin B12 is 500 to 1000 microgram by intramuscular injections. So that is all about vitamin B12. Now we will discuss various multiple choice questions. So this question was asked in NEET 2016. Vitamin B12 deficiency causes all except. And the options are neural tube defect, peripheral neuropathy, megaloblastic anemia, and demyelination. So vitamin B12 deficiency causes all this except A. Neural tube defect is caused by folic acid deficiency. So the correct answer is A. Second question, it was asked in NEET 2017. Cobalt is present in which vitamin? And the options are B1, B2, B3, and B12. So cobalt is present in vitamin B12. So the correct answer is D. Third question is, deficiency of which of the following two vitamins results in the similar type of anemia? And the options are B1 and B2, B6 and niacin, folate and B12, and B6 and B12. So deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid causes similar type of anemia, that is megaloblastic anemia. So correct answer is C. Fourth question is, all of the following are true about vitamin B12 except, and the options are methylcobalamin and deoxyarenosylcobalamin are the coenzyme forms of vitamin B12. So this option is correct. Neurological damage in vitamin B12 deficiency can be corrected by administering folate in therapeutic doses. Methylmalonyl CoA is accumulated in vitamin B12 deficiency. This option is also correct. Folic acid is trapped as N5-methyltetrahydrofolate in vitamin B12 deficiency. So option D is also correct. Option B is not correct. Neurological damage in vitamin B12 deficiency can be corrected by administering folate in therapeutic doses. It will be corrected by vitamin B12. So the correct answer is B. So that is all about multiple choice question. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and please press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.